The Last Courtesans of Bombay takes you inside the secretive world of the city's dying tawaif community, who are caught between rich cultural history and changing social mores. I'm your host Kunal Purohit, and this podcast is brought to you by the editorial team at The Swaddle and edited by Sapan, Taneja. Over months of conversations with the few remaining mujra dancers of Mumbai, I learned about the women and their desperate attempts to keep a dying tradition alive.
परफ्यूम्स की बहुत दुकानें थी यहाँ, परफ्यूम वगैरह बहुत बिका करते थे पहले, क्योंकि ये लोग परफ्यूम वगैरह यूज़ करती थी, परफ्यूम बहुत बिकते थे, परफ्यूम है लेडीज़ लोग का जो सामान है, लिपस्टिक पाउडर ये वो, इसकी भी बहुत सी दुकानें थी। अब तो सब बंद हो गई हैं, तो 8-10 हज़ार भाड़ा था, अभी 3,000-2,500 भाड़ा हो गया।
अच्छा, इतना गिर गया।
लेकिन अब सब दुकानें बंद हैं। अब देखो रोड पर, नहीं तो ये रोड पर ना आपको बहुत चहल पहल, एकदम आप देखेंगे तो हर तरफ चहल पहल मिल जा रहा है कि उजाला है, दुकानों पे शॉपिंग है, सब है। जैसे तो मैंने पूछा बच्चियाँ क्या, मुझे भी नहीं मालूम, बड़ी बड़ी लड़की टीचर हो गई है यार।
अरे अच्छा,
दो लड़की थे।
आई एम बैक टू वेयर इट ऑल स्टार्टेड एट द बच्चू सेठ की वाड़ी, द लोकेलिटी इन सेंट्रल मुंबई विच हैज सर्व्ड एज द नर्व सेंटर ऑफ मुजरा इन बॉम्बे फॉर सेंचुरीज नाउ। This is where I've been for the past 4 months, going in and out, walking its narrow alleys, constantly watched by curious and suspicious onlookers, while I tried to convince mujra performers to talk to me. I've spoken to various people in this time, trying to understand what mujra once was and what it is today. I'm nearly at the end of this 4 month long journey now, but there's one last story I want to tell you, the story of Bachu Seth Ki Wadi. Bachu Seth Ki Wadi is located on the fringes of Kamathipura, which was considered to be one of Asia's largest red light areas. Kamathipura was a creation of colonial planning, the sex industry that was meant to largely entertain British soldiers and sailors who would regularly dock at the Bombay port. Details about the Wadi's origins are very sketchy and yet fascinating. North India used to be the heart of India's mujra scene since the 18th century. Mujra performers grew in popularity and influence. Many of these performers were so influential and politically conscious that they played an active role in fighting the British in the First War of Independence in 1857. When the British crushed the revolt, they attacked the courtesans as well and persecuted them. It's believed that many of these courtesans escaped to Bombay and set up their own colony. This colony was called Bachu Seth Ki Wadi. Courtesans brought a new mujra culture to Bombay, one which became an instant hit. The sheer talent that these courtesans carried, with their poetry, their music and their dance, was immense. There's proof of this as well. A research project had revealed that this Bachu Seth Ki Wadi is responsible for producing 21 winners of Padma Awards, the country's highest civilian awards. Not just that, some of the most prolific talents in the country's films and music industries trace their roots back to this wadi. But all of this is firmly in the past.
आते हो यहाँ एंजॉय करने, हमारा पेशा हमको प्यार में तुम्हें हासिल करना ही पड़ेगा, क्योंकि प्यार दिखाऊंगी नहीं तो मेरे दीवाने कहाँ से।
बाकी मेरे घर वालों ने सबने मुझसे कांटेक्ट खत्म कर लिया है, क्योंकि मैं इस लाइन में आ गई। बोले मार तो सकते नहीं है, अपना खून है, मार नहीं पाएंगे, तो इससे रिश्ता खत्म कर दो।
रात के 4 बजे जब वो गाना बजाना बंद होता था, सीटी बजती थी, तब तक के आप हर घरों के बाहर लाइट लगी रहती थी। अभी लोग नहीं है तो लोगों ने अपने अपने धंधे, अब जब भाड़ा ही नहीं वसूल होगा तो दुकान कहाँ से चलेगी।
वेलकम टू द लास्ट कोर्टिसंस ऑफ बॉम्बे, This is a documentary podcast that goes deep inside the secretive world of Bombay's courtesans and comes out with rich tales of their history, their art, and their audacious bid to subvert patriarchy by defying gender stereotypes. Naseem Bhai, my first lead into the secretive world, is back with me. This time, I'm just walking around with him in the wadi. He's got a special connection to this place. He was born here and ended up spending his youth here as well. But his memories of that era, when the wadi was still known for its courtesans, are very fresh. The wadi is almost like a cluster of small buildings. Two lanes run parallel to each other along the length of the wadi. These lanes are narrow and unlit, with houses surrounding them on both sides. These lanes wear a shabby look. There are puddles everywhere, garbage heaps in different corners, and water pipes running across its breadth. This aimless walk feels a bit weird because mujra performers are watching us, curiously and suspiciously. They sit on both sides of the central lane, in anticipation, having been left unemployed after the unofficial ban by the cops. The doors to the kothas have also been left open, giving me a chance to peep in. But the houses are all empty and silent. Naseem Bhai tells me it wasn't always like this.
नहीं नहीं तब की रौनक तो आप को रात के चार बजे जब वो गाना बजाना बंद होता था सिटी बजती थी तब तक के आप को हर घरों के बाहर लाइट लगी रहती थी और ज़्यादातर लाइट के साथ साथ छोटे मोटे तोरण भी लोग लगा के रखते थे फूल जो अपने हिसाब से डेकोरेट अपना घर करना हिसाब से डेकोरेट रहता था हर घर के बाहर वो एक आदमी बैठा रहे फूल हाल व हार व हाथ में लिए हुए अगर चार बज गया तो लोग बाल्टियों में मेहंदी उंदी लेके चलते थे किसी के सर में लगाना किसी का यहाँ वो बादाम की इसकी उसकी थैलियाँ लेके लोग बेचते हैं ना छोटे छोटे बादाम की थैली काजू की थैली चने की मटर की सब की मतलब ऐसा ऐसा फील होता था कि चार बजे के बाद यहाँ मार्केट लगी है
सुबह की चार
हाँ सुबह चार बजे जब गाना बजाना बंद होता था तो लोग फ्री होती थी खाने वाले जैसे रोड पे सदर होटल करके होटल थी तो वहाँ के बाहर वाले लोग दिन भर सोते थे और रात में वो लोग दो चार घंटे में अपना कमा लेते थे चहल पहल का तो ऐसा था कि आप को डर और खौफ तो लगता ही नहीं था यहाँ
और आप कह रहे हैं चार बजे हाँ, के बाद ही
हाँ नहीं चालू तो हो जाता था नौ बजे गाना बजाना मतलब चार बजे के बाद लोग गाना बजाना बंद होता था तो लोग अपने खाना पीना चीज़ें लेने जो लोग बेचने वाले आ जाते थे हार फूल वाले आ जाते थे जो लड़कियां बहुत सी यहाँ से दूसरी जगह जाना है उनके लिए टैक्सी वाले लोग का बड़ी अच्छी कमाई हो जाती थी नज़दीक नज़दीक भी छोड़ते थे 300-400 रुपये उनको बच जाया करते थे हम लोग वहाँ लास्ट में सोते थे मगर हम लोगों को कभी मतलब नींद नहीं आ रही है ना तो ये समझ में आता था कि अब ये सीटी बज गई अब चार बज गए अब सो जाओ यहाँ से हिल नहीं सकते इतनी अच्छी चहल पहल रहा करती थी
Naseem Bhai is making a crucial point here. A vibrant mujra culture was not just beneficial for the performers, but it supported an entire ecosystem of businesses. From the vendors who would go from door to door selling accessories, to the taxi drivers who would often transport patrons and performers, to even the eatery in the locality. All of these businesses have now dried up.
उस वक्त आप सीख खरीद नहीं सकते इतनी भीड़ रहती थी। पार्सल के लिए दूर दूर तक के लाइन लगती थी सईद सीख कबाब मशहूर पूरे एरिया में पूरे बॉम्बे में मशहूर था सीख कबाब तो लोग आते थे तो अभी 10 लोग सुनने भी आते थे 10 लोग थोड़ा देखने दिखाने के हिसाब से भी आते थे तो उसमें आदमी आया तो खाना पीना ये वो शॉपिंग
दिस इज नॉट जस्ट अबाउट द इकोनॉमिक साइड ऑफ थिंग्स द डिक्लाइन ऑफ दिस प्लेस एंड इट्स मुजरा कल्चर हैज मेंट दैट अ वे ऑफ लाइफ इज नाउ लॉस्ट ओवर द लास्ट 4 मंथ्स I learned that different kothas had existed here as a part of a tightly knit community. A community that had rules for itself and a community that lived in strict discipline. One example of this was the fascinating way in which the community ensured that everyone fell in line.
जैसे वो इस्माइल भाई करके थे वो सुबह 4 बजे सीटी बजाते थे वो रखा गया था तो सीटी बजाएंगे तो गाना बजाना बंद या फिर 9-10 बजे के बाद सुबह मॉर्निंग में चालू इस तरह से था और चार बजे अगर आपने वो बंद कर दिया ना मुजरा तो फिर अभी आपको अगर जो गाने बजाने बैठा है वो बोलेगा भी मुझे सुनना है तो उसको एक दो घंटा रोक देंगे कि भाई अभी सिटी बजी अभी नहीं होगा फिर वो एक दो घंटे बाद अगर अपने घर में पर्सनल चालू करना चाहे तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं मगर उस वक्त ऑर्डर मानते थे कि कितना भी कोई भी आया हो और कितना भी दे रहा हो मगर आपको बंद करना है
Naseem Bhai says this exercise wasn't just about shutting the quotas on time. It extended to taking decisions as a collective and sticking to them, even at the cost of financial gains.
इसमें सबसे इन लोगों में एक बात सबसे अच्छी ये है ना कि अगर अभी टाइम जैसे जैसे मुजरे को ये लोग टाइम बोलते हैं ना, अगर वो टाइम चालू है और अल्लाह ना करे अगर किसी का इंतकाल हो गया तो एक दिन के लिए मुजरा बंद रहता है, चाहे वो गाने वाली के यहाँ इंतकाल हो, चाहे वो बजाने यानी मतलब इनके कौम के किसी में भी अगर एक का इंतकाल हो गया तो आपको वो पूरे दिन मुजरा बंद रहेगा, यानी मतलब उस दिन अगर कोई बड़ा से बड़ा सेठ भी आ गया ना तो आपको गाने बजाने का अलाउड नहीं है, आपके घर में वो बैठ सकता है, चाय पानी पी सकता है, मगर गाने बजाने का अलाउड नहीं है। जैसे अगर किसी के यहाँ मैयत हो गई ना तो ये लोग गाना बजाना नहीं करती।
स्पीकिंग टू वेरियस पीपल हियर आई रियलाइज दैट दे ऑल फर्मली बिलीव इन सेल्फ रेगुलेशन. So, the community has a strict list of do's and don'ts that everyone has to adhere to. If they don't, the community collectively imposes penalties on them. Slowly though, all of this started changing. As patronage towards mujra started drying up, desperate performers started breaking these rules. As their prestige declined, so did the community's togetherness. Anna Morcom, an academic who has extensively researched on music and dance in India, explained this slow shift to me.
They really have nothing to do with your kind of polite, quote-unquote respectable society at all. People don't even know they exist. They're just not on their radar whatsoever. Whereas, back 100 or even back in the 60s, at 70s, in towns and cities in India, but back even before that, people knew who these women were. They knew where they were artists. They knew where they were not like the domestic women, the women who were married, go on to marry, the women of the family of the people who were going to listen to them. They knew they were a different category of women, but they had connections with them. So they were integrated with your mainstream, if you like, cultural life and social life. But you can say they had a liminal status. A liminal status means they were neither fully a part of that that mainstream, and they were neither fully excluded from it. So they had, in certain contexts, they were extremely important. They were very respected. They had very important roles to play. They were called to perform for marriages, and so on and so forth. It wasn't just the private mujra, for that male audience. There were other context as well. So they had a complex, but also not that complex, relationship with the mainstream and the elite. And that is what has really broken down. They've become increasingly excluded and marginalized rather than being liminally connected,
Despite this exclusion, the community here in the Wadi continues to have some basic rules that everyone is expected to follow. One example shows this very clearly. A few years ago, this locality started seeing many police raids. The cops had said that some mujra kotas had started employing minor girls. Worried at this new trend, the community swung into action and implemented its own code of conduct. What all of this points to is something bigger than discipline. It points to a socially conscious community which was very well aware of its responsibilities. When their popularity was at its peak, the community would often come together to create social change or to contribute to different humanitarian causes.
इससे में क्या होता था कि पूरी गली में सब लड़कियां बैठ के मुजरा करती थी, जो यंग लड़कियां रहती थी तो डांस करती थी, उसमें खुलेआम रहता था, उसको जलसा कहते थे। उसमें जो वो जलसे में ये लोग कुछ पैसे नहीं लेती थी, वो जितना भी पैसा जमा होता था वो जो भी हालात उस वक्त के थे कि भाई कहीं बम ब्लास्ट हो गया या कहीं कुछ ऐसा हो गया या किसी लड़की की शादी कराना, वो उसको पूरा दे दिया जाता था। उसमें से कोई भी नहीं लेता था, ना घर वाला लेता था, ना कोई बजाने वाला लेता, ना कोई वो पूरा का पूरा उनको दे दिया जाता, इस तरह से था।
Despite the visible decline in the locality, this is one tradition that still continues.
अभी भी कोई किसी में मरता उड़ता है ना तो लोग सब ऐसा, अभी जैसे मुहर्रम का महीना आता है, यहाँ जुलूस वगैरह शरबत और समझ लीजिए 12 दिन खाने का इंतजाम रहता है, आम लंगर रहता है 12 दिन। आप कोई भी आदमी आए, कहीं का भी हिंदू मुसलमान सिख कोई भी आके खाना खा सकता है। तो वही लोग एक एक घर से अपना जो भी इनकी ताकत रहती है वो सेलेक्ट करके देती है।
दिस देन इज अ कॉमन स्ट्रैंड अमॉन्ग द कम्युनिटी आई फाइंड। Many of them, despite everything that has happened, are trying to hold on to old values and traditions. They are trying to recreate and reclaim what the profession meant at one point in time. But time is what is running out. Most mujra performers I met, from Reena to Zoya to the countless others who did not want to be interviewed, told me how they can't wait to leave the industry behind. I remember meeting one mujra performer who told me that her son was getting married, but she couldn't tell the bride's family what she did. The government's repeated efforts to stigmatize them, coupled with the way society looks at them, has meant that most courtesans don't want their daughters to take the trade up. Strangely, these courtesans don't have high demands to make. All that they often want is just that society listens to them and understands them better. Here is Anna Morcom again.
I mean, the whole trouble with these campaigns against these women has been people haven't really been ready to talk to them or listen to them. Well, I mean, some people have. Nowadays, this has changed, but still very little. So the dance bar ban, you know, talking to bar girls and saying, well, you know, you're exploited, it's against your dignity, and they will say, no, we want to work. You know, oh, maybe it's not the most glamorous, you know, well, maybe it's not the high, most high level job in the world, but we want to work. Please leave us alone. We're fine. And then people saying, no, it's against your dignity. It's immoral. It's awful. And so on and so forth. But I mean, at what stage are we able to just simply listen and say they have a very different reality? They have a very different background, and their communities were structured in complement to your mainstream society, where you had women were very, you know, kept out of the public sphere, if not actually, you know, veiled, but kept out of the public sphere, kept, you know, respectable in those senses. The courtesans were very, very complementary, actually. And it was a system that worked in those ways. Whether you agree with it or not, it was the system.
For now, though, hardly anyone is listening to these performers. The art of mujra stares at an uncertain future. These women may very well be the last remaining courtesans of Bombay. This was the final episode in a four-part series called The Last Courtesans of Bombay. You can find the entire series on theswaddle.com, SoundCloud, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, and Google Podcasts. This series is brought to you in collaboration with The Swaddle. This podcast would not have been possible without contributions from many, many people. A special shout out to Edward Lung for providing us fantastic music for the podcast. You can check his work out on his YouTube channel, The Interzone Collective. We'd also like to thank Naseem Bhai, Syed Furkan, Raish Sheikh, Anna Morcom, Veena Oldenburg, and Anubhuti Mata for their support throughout this project. And lastly, a note of gratitude for the countless tawaifs who opened up and told us some of the most intimate stories of their lives.